Welcome to Investigators of Arkham. I'm JP from Northern Lights over Arkham, and this time I will be looking at the brand new mystic investigator, Gloria Goldberg. Let's get started. Gloria Goldberg was released in the novella Dark Revelations in October of 2020. We still don't know when we will see her normal version released in a deluxe expansion box, but I hope that day will come soon next year. Let's first look at Gloria's investigator card a bit closer. Gloria Goldberg, the writer, is a mystic. She has 5 in willpower, a 4 in intellect, a 2 in combat, and a 1 in agility. She has the clairvoyant trait. She has 5 health and 9 sanity. With her stat line, Gloria has a high willpower and will do well as a mystic. Her high intellect also makes her a good clue gatherer without any tricks from the mystic spells or events. Her combat of 2 means she really needs to get some offensive spells if you are planning on defeating any enemies with her. Her agility of 1 also means she is bad at evading and vulnerable to treacheries that test agility. Gloria's special ability is you choose the investigator order during the mythos phase. What this means is that if you are playing Gloria in a multiplayer game, you can decide in which order players draw cards from the encounter deck. In a true solo game, this ability does nothing, as you are the only player and will always draw the top card of the encounter deck, unless some other effect makes you draw differently. Gloria also has a reaction trigger ability. When you look at the one or more cards from the encounter deck, look at one additional card and choose one non-elite card amongst them. Either discard it, put it on top of the encounter deck, or place it face down beneath Gloria Goldberg. Max 3 cards beneath her. Her elder sign effect is +1, look at the top card of the encounter deck. Okay, let's stop here to talk a bit more about Gloria's reaction triggered ability. She can basically mold the top of the encounter deck to sweep the investigators and take the sting out of the encounter deck's power. A willpower skill test treachery can be forwarded to a strong willpower mystic to deal with. An enemy can be directed to the guardian, armed to the teeth, and so on. This is a really powerful ability, but you need tools to utilize it. We will talk a bit more about them later, after we have read through Gloria's deck building options. Gloria's deck size is 30 cards. Secondary class choice. At deck creation, choose guardian, seeker, or rogue. She can take mystic cards level 0 to 5, neutral cards level 0 to 5 and up to 10 level 0 to 1 events or skills of your chosen secondary class. Her signature cards are 3 copies of Physic Sensitivity and 3 copies of Prophecy of the End, and she also takes one random basic weakness into the deck at deck creation. We still don't know what her signature cards do, as she has not been released outside of the novella release. We will look at the replacement cards a bit later, but let's first talk a bit about the secondary classes. I have tried all of the secondary classes with Gloria now, and the Guardian is definitely the clear multiplayer secondary class to choose. With the added Guardian class events and skills, Gloria can really boost her ability to help her fellow investigators in the mythos phase and deal with the encounter deck. The Seeker is maybe the best for the true solo investigator. The Seeker event and skill cards boost Gloria's ability to move and get clues, but also add some new good offensive events to her card pool. At first, the Rogue of class was a bit of a mystery to me. After some deck building trial and error, I finally found an interesting build for Gloria that makes her into a flexible mystic for either true solo or multiplayer play. All in all, I think the Rogue is a flexible choice if you don't want to play as a guardian of glass or a seeker of glass. So play around with it and basically just have fun. Next, let's look at Gloria's replacement signature cards. Gloria's signature asset is Ruth Westmacott. She is a 3-cost asset and has 2 intellect icons and a wild icon. She has the ally and artist traits. She is Gloria Goldberg deck only replacement. Reaction triggered ability. When an investigator fights, attempts to evade, or initiates a skill test on an encounter card, discard an encounter card that shares the trait with that card from beneath Gloria Goldberg. Reduce the difficulty of this skill test by 2. She has 2 health and 3 sanity, and she takes up the ally slot. I have to confess, I have not played Ruth onto the table even once when playing Gloria. I feel like what Ruth offers isn't that useful compared to, for example, Alyssa Graham, a mystic ally that lets Gloria utilize her ability of manipulating the counter deck each round. I get what Ruth does. With her help, tucking cards beneath Gloria makes more sense than just discarding the encounter cards. But still, I would rather have Alyssa Graham in play and just commit Ruth to an intellect test for 3 intellect. I don't even feel that I would want to spend experience to Gloria for a charisma to be able to have both in place at the same time. Let's look at Gloria's replacement signature weakness next. Liber Omnium Finium is a weakness with the end times trait. Gloria Goldberg deck only replacement. Revelation, draw a random non-weakness encounter card from beneath Gloria Goldberg. That card gains peril. Its effect cannot be cancelled, and you get -2 to all skills while resolving its effect. If that card is an enemy, it immediately attacks you. If no card is drawn by this effect, shuffle this card back into your deck. This weakness feels really mild. Remember that when you are using your reaction trigger ability with Gloria, you can either discard the encounter card, put it on top of the encounter deck, or put it beneath Gloria. I have not yet put any cards beneath Gloria because of this weakness, as you can just discard the card and not have to deal with it for a while. I can see a case in multiplayer where the encounter deck will get reshuffled more often, that some really nasty encounter cards could be more beneficial to be placed underneath Gloria. But I would perhaps never put an enemy beneath her, because if you pull this weakness, if that enemy comes into play, it will attack you immediately. If you don't want to keep reshuffling this weakness repeatedly into your deck and redrawing it later, I suggest put one really mild encounter card beneath Gloria, and when you hit this weakness, just resolve that. Overall, Gloria is a really fun investigator to play, either true solo or in a multiplayer game. The encounter card manipulation is great fun and makes for some comical situations if you happen to forget the order you were planning for them to be resolved and deal the wrong cards to your fellow investigators. The trick for playing Gloria is that you need to have assets or events in your deck that let you look at the top of the encounter deck, otherwise you will not get to use her full potential while playing. I hope you found this Investigators of Arkham episode to be helpful. Let me know in the comments below what you think about Gloria and have you had the chance to play her yet. Thanks for watching, and until next time.